The weekend, all the football-loving people have been waiting for the MTN 8 final, Wafa Wafa. It's the big one, it's massive. Bloemfontein Celtic up against Orlando Pirates, the Buccaneers from Orlando. My name is Neto, N-E-T-O Chemani, and this is Channel Africa with sports from an African perspective. Joining us on Africa at Play this afternoon is former Kaizer Chiefs and Mamelodi Sundowns striker. He used to bang in these goals with all sorts of body parts. If it's not with his legs, it will always be with his head. Sometimes even with his knee. Everything counts as long as it's at the back of the net. Katlego Mphela, a very good afternoon.
Good afternoon to you and good afternoon to the listeners.
Thanks for joining us on Africa at Play.
Thank you for having us.
Also with us is Joseph Tukutuku Makhanya. I'm still interested to know, where does this Tukutuku nickname come from? Joseph, a very good afternoon. Thanks for joining us on Africa at Play.
A very good afternoon to you, sir.
Tukutuku Makhanya, where does this Tukutuku come from?
It comes from the supporters, bruh. I used to rise them there. So I was nicknamed Tukutuku on my first debut. First debut game, I got that nickname. So all along, I didn't know that nickname up until I made my debut Pirates. It was 2001 when we played against Arrows in Palm Springs. So I came on as a sub. Then from there onwards, I had that nickname.
Selima Tunza.
Selim Natunzi. Yeah, you come a long way with the SABC one. Great stuff. Gentlemen, let's get on to it. It's the big one. You can only get to the final if you've done well. I was interested to see Bloemfontein Celtic, how they've performed. They edged Mamelodi Sundowns, the giants of African football, 1-0 in the quarterfinals, went on to the semifinals against SuperSport United, and they've done well. 1-1 draw in the first leg and 1-0 win in the second leg. Sometimes that's what you need. You just need those 1-0 victories to get to the finals.
Yeah, I mean, it's Wafa Wafa. It's the winner takes all. There's no second chances. So, but that, I'm not surprised with Celtics. I think it's just a continuation from last season. Even last season, they were doing well. Hence, they're in the top eight. So I'm not surprised. I think they're playing exciting football. They're just continuing from where Siyama left off. And they're doing well, you know. And hopefully in the final the score goes. I think if they take their chances, they've got a chance of clinching the cup.
Talking about Letlhomela Siyama, it's also good to see the synergy from a man who's played for the side, and they move on and they've got another man who's also played for the side, former captain John Maduka, taking the reins and also not doing bad. Looking at even their play during the Confederations African football, they've done well. Dramatic penalty shootout victory, but at the end of the day, it's victory. And those games, they give you confidence going into the cup final.
Yeah, it's good to see that former players are representing their teams. You know, it's happening everywhere in the world. You saw Chelsea, they've got Lampard. Manchester United, they've got Solskjaer. So I think it's starting to be a norm, you know, to get former players to coach teams that they played for. And then Celtics, their second final in two seasons. So it's not surprising that even in Africa they're doing well. It seems like they're gaining that experience, you know. And then I'm happy for them because we know that they've got passionate supporters. So if they can get something for them, and they've been through a lot. And I think last season they were almost sold. So it's good for them that to be in these finals. If they win this one, it will also help.
Great stuff, Jules. A big one, Orlando Pirates. You must have had smiles since the beginning of this tournament. 1-0 win against Cape Town City. They've done well against arch rivals Kaizer Chiefs, who are struggling at the moment, and we all know their issues. But at the end of the day, the records do not say you've got financial constraints or you've got administrative issues, you can't sign players. 5-0 on aggregate, 3-0 in the first leg, 2-0 in the second leg. Impressive performance.
Yeah, impressive indeed, because of if you look at what has been transpiring at Pirates, is that from last season, they had a coach who didn't have a good preseason with them. He only joined them in the middle of the season. Now he gets to know the setup of South African football. He gets to know the players better. Hence, you've seen how they've been applying themselves. Because of, I think there's an there's a change in their approach, especially in terms of playing. Because of, as you know, Pirates used to concede a lot of goals. So I've seen a lot of a different approach since the coach came back. Because of, I think they don't want to concede more goals. Because of the end of the day, as you know, that tournament football is all about making sure that you shut the back door and you take your chance. And they've done quite well. And also, you've seen them in the league as well. They haven't lost a match, even though they've got so many draws. But I also like to believe that there's still room of improvement. But of is they haven't gelled that well. The way we want to see them play. Because of there were a whole lot of new signing that were made. So it takes time for them to get to know and understand each other. But having said so, at least they are building that out of confidence of not losing games. So. It is a confident booster, and there are a lot of players that have signed, and what a way to start a career by also clinching maybe a MTN 8 final or the trophy. So meaning the very same players that they've signed, I mean, second month they find themselves on the MTN 8 final.
They find themselves on the MTN 8 final. Orlando Pirates have a tendency of getting to the finals, only to freeze. Can we expect a different approach this time around?
Yeah, I like to believe that they won't freeze this time because of there's a whole set of new players, and those players they want to do well, especially for the team. And judging by the way Celtic, you've seen that the Celtic, they've made sure that they've been saving players, so they are gunning for the MTN 8 final. Because of this, they are saying it's their second final in 2 months, and yeah, they don't want to lose this one. So it's going to be a tough match for Orlando Pirates. So I hope that complacency doesn't creep in into their team. Because of at the end of the day, they need to respect the Celtic. Because of they are where they are. Because of they deserve it. So, and I've seen the past two games of Celtic. The coach rested all his players. Mm-hmm. He has been playing MTC players or the so-called second string squad players. So it gets to show you how seriously do they take the final. And also, again, if you look, they've got a game on Wednesday. So I don't know how is the coach going to go about it. Because on Wednesday, they've got a game and he's been resting players. And also, you need your sharpness as well. Because it's a final, you need also to have your players having that mental sharpness as well on the field of play. Because it's a final, you might try to rest players and avoid injuries. So when it comes to the last game, you find that players are not performing because of the sharpness has gone away. Because of it's been, I think, three games that he has been resting the players. So I don't know what's his take on it. Will we see maybe on Wednesday, maybe playing the very same team that he's been playing, or the guys that he wants to see on the final? So also, again, playing them on Wednesday, it means he'll risk a situation of injuries. Whereas Pirates, at the other hand, they played Saturday, so they've got the full week to rest. So it's an advantage to Pirates. So it's a trophy for Pirates to lose.
We've seen Bloemfontein Celtic in recent times, Katlego, struggling financially, administration, but it's just interesting to see how re-energized they are in the mix of all those challenges. They're doing better than before.
Yeah, it seems like it's sorted now. You know, you see the way they play, players are happy. You know, the mood, you can see the mood from playing. I think it's sorted now. Hence I say they need this money. But as Joseph said, it's a tricky one because he rested these players, his core, for the past three games. Now they have to come into the last game, and I think they're gonna be rusty in the finals. So are you playing them now to risk the injuries, or are you gonna risk him playing the final without playing them four games? So it's a tricky one, but I'm sure he knows what he's doing. But the end of the day, it's a final. You know, final, you don't need motivation. You just go and give it all out. So. On my side, I hope they win Celtic. I hope they win this trophy.
We also know how vibrant they can be with their spectators. You know, Siwelele people with their green and white. Where they arrive, they take over. They take over the singing. You must do the job on the field of play. This time around, the situation is different, all because of the ongoing disruptions of COVID-19. How will this final be without spectators?
I don't know. They came a long way without supporters. They surprised Sundowns, they surprised SuperSport without supporters. But you know, the final is the final. I don't know if they're going to get stage fight or not. But they've been in finals before. I think they've won Telkom before.
Yeah, they've been in finals before.
I think Jog Majuga was a good player for them. Huh? He was a captain. He won trophies, so he's going to instill that mentality in them. You know, say, you know, just calm down and whatever. But I don't see them having problems without supporters, you know. Even the whole tournament, they've scored something like 18 goals already. Last season it was 16 goals, the whole tournament. So I don't think it's going to be a problem. I think they're going to score goals. But as Dogo said, Pirate made some good signings. And then they're not conceding now. You know, they've signed Tlatswayo and other. And it seems like they're gelling very well. So if Celtic don't take their chances, Pirates will punish them because of their experience. So.
Jose, back to you. The impact players that can trouble Bloemfontein Celtic from Orlando Pirates.
Hey, I'm not happy that Lach is injured, bro.
Yeah.
So his impact on the Pirates side is because of sometimes as a team, in a team you need a player that will make other players to have that confidence. So he's one of those players that whenever he's on the field of play, other players they tend to at least have maybe a load being reduced on their shoulders. So I'd like to believe that Vincent Pule can still do the job because he's been doing quite well in the past matches. He's been scoring goals, so surely going to the final, his confidence will be up there. I'd also like to see Hoto stepping up. There's also Cabadino Mango, there's Terence Vogamanja. So they've got quite a good team and also a capable personnel who can step up and do something on the day. So, but I still believe that they can still clinch a trophy without a large team. So I'm hoping that players are ready to step in and take the trophy.
Katlego, when you take on Orlando Pirates, it's a side that can trouble you any minute of the game. They've got speedy players. Yeah. They cut the ground anytime, any day. They know where to find their target man, and they can cause you trouble. If you don't believe it, ask Kaizer Chiefs. Who will stop Orlando Pirates?
Yeah, I think it's going to be a difficult one. As Dugu said, you have Mahongo, you have Pule, you have Ocho can always trouble you. You know, they fast, they speedy. So, but also Celtics, you have the guy who was a pilot, Shabalala. He wants to prove a point. You also have Mabena friend who wants to prove a point. So it's going to be difficult. I think it's going to be an open game. Why wait? Because it's a final. Someone has to win. So I think it's going to be an open game. And but hey, Pirates, they've got depth, to be honest. Their squad is stronger than Celtics. So I said, if they don't take their chances, they will lose this one.
It's the MTN 8 final. Even the MTN 8 trophy is here. We just don't know whether it's going to the Free State or it's coming to Gauteng. But that will only be seen, that will only be experienced come Saturday when the two giants meet at the Durban's Moses Mabhida Stadium. Prediction?
I don't know, but I just want to see goals because, as you know, MTN... MTN is not only for the teams that are participating, they're also doing it for the community. So there's a thing called goals for charity. You know, each goal that is scored during the 90 minutes of the match equals to 20,000 rand. So far we've scored 18 goals. It's what, 260k. So after the tournament, that money is going to be donated to the charity of the choice of MTN 8 and the PSL. So I'm just hoping for goals so that we can help people. You know, we make 2020 because, you know, COVID-19 came with a lot of things. People were retrenched, and so people need this money, and there's other lots of competitions to be won. Maybe Dugu will explain further.
It's the MTN 8 final. Are we likely to see 8 goals? 4-4?
I'm hoping that Pirates score more goals, like Katlego said. The end of the day, MTN is also trying to make sure that everybody's being covered. There's also, supporters, there's a last fan standing, which stands out at the 1 million rand cash prize money. And also, there are I mean, there are 8 million rands worth of prizes that need to be won. And also, you just need to be an MTN subscriber. Make sure that you've got your starter pack, MTN starter pack, and you opt in by dialing *144*8# and recharge with 10 rand or more. And increase your chances also. There's an IOVA app that you download. Increase your chances also there by predicting score on the final. So the more at least you enter, the more you recharge, then the better you stand a chance of winning some of those prizes. Like Killa has said, MTN is trying to tell like the soccer loving nation that let's remake, we're helping you to remake a 2020 by offering all these kinds of prizes. So it's worth our time, Baba. So I'm hoping that Pirates win this one.
When you watch Pirates play and you remember your days of play, which player comes to mind and you're like, yeah, you see this boy used to watch me playing?
I like to believe that Pirates, they always sign players that like similar. So you look at Lodge, you look at Vincent Pule, those are players who need to make things happen. So that was that was the kind of player that I used to it was either maybe I needed to create opportunity for my strikers, so which Orlando Pirates players that I've mentioned, they do that. So Lodge, Pule, similar type. Yeah.
You used to score goals for Mamelodi Sundowns and Kaizer Chiefs. You've done very well to have played for the giants of the game in this country. Any player that you look at Bloemfontein Celtic and you're thinking, I know Pirates have arrived, but this guy can cause them trouble?
So does this boy, number nine, he's still a bit rusty. He still needs to be polished, but I see a potential there. When given a chance, he can punish you, but the problem with him is that he needs a lot of chances to get a goal. Mm-hmm. Even Mabena is coming, you know, I think he's their main man. And as I said, he wants to pull a point. You know, he's been consistent from last season, so I think Palace needs to watch him as well. And then there's a boy on the right flank, Figizol. Mm-hmm. He's fast as well. So, yeah, those two players, they must be careful.
The coaching staff, you take John Maduka, who has spent almost his entire career in South Africa, has done very well from Malawi, Southern Africa. He's part of the region. He's doing very well for himself. Lihlonolo Siyama is one of them. Pitso Mosimane is one of them, now coaching Egyptian giants. He's already even won trophies. Mm-hmm. At one stage, I went through an article that says he's the coach of the season, and I'm like, but he just arrived after seven matches.
But, you know, they after seven like matches.
So my point is, local coaches are doing well, yeah, and they are climbing the ladder. So are we likely to see Lihlonolo Siyama troubling the German mentor?
Yeah.
John Maduka.
I think he will, because not only him, I think the whole technical team consists of local coaches and their former players. So they understand the culture of the team. That's why maybe they've been doing so well, because the guys understand the culture of the team. And they, when the players come in, they tell them what to do. This is how we work. This is how Celtics are supposed to be represented. So coaches like Pito, Ulani, then, you know, it's good to have players, their coaches, like maybe want to coach us later stage. Maybe wants to coach, and it's a path for us. They're opening a way for us to, you know, when we get the more doubts about local coaches. So I think they're doing well. And as for Maduka, as I said, last year he was in the final. This year he's in the final again. So he's doing very well for himself. And hopefully he'll win it. And I just hope he'll win it because, as I said, because of the supporters and stuff, it's a club that everyone loves. You know, Celtics, one of those clubs, you know. So just hope they'll win it.
Jose Makhanya, the German mentor, Zimbabwe.
It's time to deliver, Baba. Yeah. It's time to deliver. I mean, the coach was appointed last season. Everybody was happy that we found a new coach. So the pressure now is intensifying because of the result I needed. It's a big team. So result I needed. So I'm hoping that he starts with the MTN 8, because of there'll be three trophies this season to challenge for. So starting with the MTN 8, which is a trophy to open the season campaign. So I'm hoping that he start with this one so that at least it becomes easier to challenge other trophies as well. Because of the longer it takes, because of if you check Paris, it's been 6 years that they've been won a trophy. So they can continue adding numbers onto those 6 years. So I'm hoping that he does win a trophy, because of, like I told you, that the pressure is on him to deliver. So he better start with this one.
Moses Mabhida Stadium has become a cup final host. It has become a venue for cup finals. And Orlando Pirates players, very experienced, they can play anywhere.
They can play anywhere. At the end of the day, they won't be supporters. So it's not their home ground, but it's their happy hunting effort. Because of even the MTN 8 that they won, because of, they've won it twice. So one of those trophies, they won it there in Moses Mabhida, so it's their happy hunting ground. So at the end of the day, they won't be supporters, but I like to believe that the quality that they have on their squad will have a major impact, especially against a Celtic that has got players who are still hungry and looking to impress. So at the end of the day, it's all about making sure that they execute their plan and stay dominant. Because at the end of the day, everybody's expecting that Pirates, they have to do well on the final, and with the quality on their side, they have to do well.
Plum Celtic can cause an upset at any day. They've proven to be that kind of a team.
Yeah, they also love Devon. I remember we played the final against them, Moses Mabhida, the Telkom, they beat us 1-0. So they can, yeah, as I said, final is a final. You never know how it's going to go. So let's hope players are ready. We'll go all out, and Celtic can upset Pirates, as we said. But they, as I said, their squad is they've got a strong squad. Pirates, they've made good signings this year. And as Dogo said, the coach needs to deliver. The honeymoon is over now. So just because there's no supporters, you know, Celtics, they've got the 12 men that support. It's not there, so I think it's taking a bit of something from them as well. So I don't know how it's going to go, but they've done well so far to beat the SuperSport and to reach our former champions and to beat Sunrise. It means they can also upset Pirates.
Dugo, are we likely to see penalty shootouts?
I hope not, because of
goals for charity.
I hope not, because of those goals, those penalties don't count. They don't count as goals for charity. So we hope for a high-scoring game. Maybe a 4-3, a 3-1, but as long as Pirates win, I'm okay.
Great stuff. Your last words?
Just for the supporters or the customers of MTN, they mustn't forget that there's still time to enter this competition. So they must just get an MTN SIM card, you know, star opt in by dialing *144*8#. You will charge you 10 rand no more, and the more you'll charge, the more you stand the chance of winning all this. These great prizes, and yeah, there's also a home viewing experience. You know, if you win, it's like, what do they do? MTN takes the stadium to you. So we as legends will come to your house if you are a winner, then we watch the game with you. MTN will come and install the TV, the decoder, and other things there. There's also gonna be a chef, so it's a stadium experience. And two legends are gonna be there with you. You can invite 7 of your friends, and yeah, these are some of the prizes that you can win.
Great stuff. There you have it. Lots of prizes to look forward to. Dugo, final remarks?
A win for Pirates.
There you have it. Sweet and short. A win for Pirates. You are on Channel Africa. This is Africa at Play. Channel Africa with sports from an African perspective. For Channel Africa Sport, I'm Neto and Itio Chemani.